To do this, a sliding and rotating bolt is introduced. This has a double function. First, it pushes the round forward from the feed position into the loaded position. Then it locks off the action while the weapon is fired. In the majority of weapons, using a series of lugs machined on the bolt itself. These slot into corresponding recesses in the body of the weapon. For a weapon to fire, a sharp blow must be struck on the base of the cartridge. In this sniper rifle, the striker is set inside the bolt, powered by a mainspring and secured to the cocking piece. To fire, of course, you need a trigger. As the bolt is pushed forward, the face of the cocking piece gets held back by the nose of the sear. The same act of loading compresses the mainspring between the striker collar and the front of the shroud. With the bolt locked and the firing pin held back in this fashion, the weapon is said to be cocked and ready to fire. Pressing the trigger releases the sear and with it the firing pin. Once fired, the spent case must be extracted. So, unlock the bolt. On this weapon, the extractor is a spring-loaded claw that grips the base of the cartridge and pulls it back into the body along with the bolt. There, extracted, but not yet ejected from the weapon. Again, on this particular rifle, the ejector is also spring-loaded and set in the face of the bolt. As the case is withdrawn, this now automatically reasserts to force the fired cartridge away from the bolt and out of the weapon. One final item, and we can close the chapter on manual weapons. The magazine. No more hand loading of single rounds. Now we can fire as many rounds as this will hold without reloading. Insert it here, into the body. Each time the bolt is drawn back and a round ejected, a spring inside the magazine pushes another up into its path. When the bolt is moved forward, it forces a new round into the chamber. The overall operation of a weapon can be seen now in terms of a continuous cycle. Feed, cock, load, lock, fire, unlock, extract, eject.